I'm just trying to get paid.
Okay, wrestling fans, we're back for match number two, and Frankie Flow against Kenny Bengal.
Frankie Flow and Kenny, you know, this is the feud that just doesn't seem to end. These two can't stand one another.
Well, and we know this is going to be a street fight, so that means that anything and everything is legal.
How bizarre is it? Luck of the draw of all people, these two drew each other because, you know, no love lost between the Flows and Team Shazam, that's for sure.
Well, this feud's been going on now for about 3-4 months.
Oh, where's Bengal
going? And it will
going?
Come to an end. December 20th, Christmas Chaos, Allendale, New Jersey. Tag titles are on the line. The Flows against Team Shazam. And that will be in a 15-foot steel cage match.
Yeah, and Frankie Flow a little flustered. He's behind you, Frankie. Frankie can't hear us over this crowd reaction here in Paramus. But, I mean, take a look at this. He cowered. I'm not going to call it coward. It's a pretty smart thing to do. Straight boot to the head. Hey, if this thing was Paul's camera anywhere, he might be onto something here. Picks him up, and lo and behold, street fight it is.
Tony Martin, why don't you let the fans out there know something about cage matches and how dangerous they are?
Absolutely. 15 feet of steel. All surrounded, all four participants, Team Shazam, and the Flows, it all comes to a head. Christmas Chaos, it's going to be a fight.
Well, you know, that's the way to end this feud. That's the only way the wrestlers want it, the fans want it, the promoters signed it. Christmas Chaos, December 20th in Allendale, Guardian Angel Church. You will see it end one way or another.
Guardian Angel Church fans, go to ecpw1.com for all the details. As you continue to watch Frankie Flow, boy, I don't know how Frankie can contain himself. Look at this reversal into the guardrail. Oh, right in the small of his back.
You know, Frankie Flow in phenomenal condition. His body can withstand a lot of punishment because he has that muscle mass to absorb it.
Yet not to sell Kenny Bengal short, I don't agree with all the things that he does inside that ring. In fact, he's very nasty with the stuff he does. And there's a shot right there to the kidneys. Oh, Flow is feeling it. But nothing to take away from Kenny Bengal. He's just very young and extremely brash. And I think when this Dan the Man took him under his wing, he kind of brainwashed the youngster a bit, didn't he, Gino?
Well, you could see the attitude of Dan the Man rubbing off on Kenny Bengal.
Yet the Flows have reunited. They're stronger than ever. Definitely family. Blood is much thicker than water for the Flows.
You know, this action's right up and close and personal with the fans.
Yeah, it's what happens when you come out here live and watch us live, and there's nothing like seeing us live. So fans, go to ecpw1.com. You gotta take a look. We're coming to your area. We're coming to your town.
You wanna find out about the rest of the 2014 schedule and the 2015 schedule, go to our website, ecpw1.com. And right now, it's been all Kenny Bengal from the get-go.
Yeah, and a spin wheel kick right to the face. Spin wheel kick. You know, here's the thing about ecpw1.com. It's very interactive. You click on the links, you can find out the active roster, find out where we're going to be, find out the matches, dream matches that are coming to your area. Wow, that's something. Steel cage, 15 foot high, the most dangerous match in all professional wrestling. And there can only be one team that walks out winners and one team that loses.
You know, that night, not only are the belts on the line, but their careers of all four combatants are basically on the line.
It's a dangerous, dangerous night. Anything can happen to that cage, and I don't put it out of realm. With the high-flying ability of Junior Flow, God only knows what's going to come out of that contest. Back knife-edge chop. Wow, right into the pectoral region.
You know, Kenny Bengal has really come a long way, and whether you like him or don't, you got to appreciate the talent that this young kid has, and he brings to the ring each and every night.
And he's so put together, too. I mean, not to sell him short, but when you're standing next to Frankie Flow, it's one of those things where He'll make mice out of, or men out of mice. I mean, Flo is just a tremendously put together, very well-conditioned athlete, as are many here at ECPW. And Flo is just about had enough. He's choking away at him, Gino. So flagrant. Street fight, no rules. It's all within the realm.
And that's right. Frankie just said it. This is a street fight. Everything's legal.
Yeah, I mean, he's about had enough with this young, brash Kenny Bengal. Bengal has an attitude a mile long. There was a point in time here when he first came to ECPW. Fans love this guy. But he just kind of went to some shortcuts there and kind of derailed. And, you know, it's very sad to see a young man like that go down the wrong road. Oh, heads up. Street fight it is. Flo's not playing around. He grabs this chair and
everything's
no.
legal.
All legal. That's as legal as a side headlock jam.
Oh, Kenny's trying to get away. He's trying to get under that ring.
I can't say I blame him. That's the second time he's running. But
you know, Dan the Man has taught Kenny Bengal a lot of things. He taught him how to get away from danger, how to hide, how to get out of the way. And now, right now.
Oh, look at that slam on
the floor. Is a house of fire.
Wow. You saw in our opening, you saw Flo do that to Shane Douglas. Who doesn't know who that guy is? And now he's doing the same, passing it down a generation onto his Kenny Bengal.
Another chair.
One wasn't enough. Flo's emptying out all the furniture here in the beautiful Elks Lodge, right here in Paramus, 210, Route 10. Come join us, fans. There's nothing like seeing action and Bengal's all tangled up in a chair. The street fight is really taking its toll.
I'll tell you what, the tide has turned, and now Frankie Flow is in well command.
Oh,
what's he going to do with these two chairs?
Oh, it looks like he's setting up the furniture here.
Now, those chairs are steel, metal chairs. They are not folding chairs. There is no give.
Absolutely none. And there's no way to tell a chair to lighten up. But he just gouged him right into the stomach. Bengal's looking for higher ground, it appears. Flowing and letting him get out of there.
You know, there's a lot of bad blood between these teams. And you can see it here in this singles match. But when the four of them get together.
Oh, no. Here we go. Oh, he went for the suplex.
He blocked it.
Is he going to drop on those chairs?
Kenny Bengal.
Bengal with the reversal. Oh. Are you kidding me? Oh, my goodness. Right on that. That's in the same small of the back that was injured,
you know,
on those guardrails from the outside.
We touched on this earlier. Because Frankie Flow is in such good condition, he's able to withstand that.
Two. Oh, my goodness. He actually kicked out of that. Man, if that had been just a mere man, it would have taken 100 for him to kick out.
Yeah. The average person's not walking away from that.
But how much did it wear him down in this street fight? And, boy, we are witnessing a street fight.
Look at the welts on his back. When he gets up, if the cameraman can look at it, it's already black and blue.
Man, oh, man, did that take. Just how much of a toll did it take? Frankie Flo kicked out, but the real question is, how bad is he down right now?
And will this affect him not only tonight? Uh-oh.
A ladder? Are you kidding? A ladder? As if the chairs weren't enough. Heads up as he's sliding in the ring. Flo trying to still fight.
Oh.
Hey, he drop kicked it right into him.
Well, win, lose, or draw, will that injury come into effect not just tonight, but on December 20th for Christmas Chaos?
Yeah, just how much are these two taking out of each other? Hot and heavy, and man, some time has passed by in this contest where they're just blistering each other with everything that they got. What in the world is Flo setting them up for here?
Oh, my God.
Back burst.
Now Kenny Bengal has the bad back.
And Flo, he was able to get him up. Bad back and all. Flo is fighting back. Rearranging the furniture here. Yeah. What in the world is he going for here? Got him over. Look at
maybe
that.
It.
Look at the way he's got that back torqued, you know. Boy, if anybody knows anything about personal pain
he's
holds.
Ready to tap.
Oh, he's ready to give this thing up.
Look at the pain he's in.
Bengal's
Dan the Man.
Where did Dan the Man come from? Boy, he saw there was danger. And are you kidding me? Oh, come on. We're in the perfectly good match here this week. I really want to see.
The referee's throwing this one out.
He's throwing this one out. This thing is done.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has
as he hammers down.
No contest. Due to the run-in from Dan the Man of Team Shazam.
That's a shame because I believe that Frankie Flo was on the verge of winning that match.
Yeah, sorry, just had to tell the fans.
And now he's going after Dan the Man.
I wish
fans, this will come to a head December 20th, Christmas Chaos.
Christmas Chaos. Both teams 15 foot high steel cage.
And this one's not over. They're not done.
They're not done. They're fighting all the way to the back.
We talked about the black and blue of Frankie Flo's back. Look at it.
Yeah, I can't believe he's even walking at this point. And look at Bengal. Bengal kind of took a back seat there, didn't he?
They're going outside.
They're going all the way out there.
Back to the locker.